Hi everyone, it's Lynnea. Today I am playing with some items from the brand new LDRS Creative Summer Collection 1 release. So I have this gorgeous Tropical Floral stamp set. I'll be using the coordinating die as well. But what's really exciting about this stamp set is that it pairs with the Tropical Floral Slimline Stencil set. There are multiple stencils so you can have shading and dimension and easily add color to this Tropical Floral stamp set. And I'm going to show you just how I like to use this. So we're going to go super speedy here because in the end it is just ink blending, but here's how I'd like to do this. I cut a piece of cardstock to be about 8.5 inches tall by, I think I did 4.5 inches wide, bigger than what I need essentially is what I'm doing. And then I'm taping this right into the corner of my Misty stamping tool. On top of that, I'm going to start with layer 1A of the Tropical Floral Slimline Stencil Set, butting that right into that bottom left-hand corner of my Misty. And I'm just going to start ink blending. So for my greens here, I used Prickly Pear Perfection, Key Lime Pie, and then I will switch this out for layer 1C, again, popping that right into the corner, and we'll go in with 4 leaf, which is my darkest green. So you can see, even though this is sped up, how quickly and easily this image is already coming together. I'm coming in here with 2A, which is going to be some of these little flowers, not the main flowers, but kind of the surrounding ones. And I used Pink Tutu. For layer 2B, I'll be using Soft Kisses, and then Fandango to finish up. Keeping my cardstock in the corner, taped in place, and then putting the stencils right in that corner makes it so that I don't have to align anything. I know everything is going to line up just perfectly without any effort at all, but you don't have to do this. You can just as easily lay your piece of cardstock out on your work surface and just carefully line up your stencils. Or you can stamp first and then stencil. However, if you stamp first and add your ink blending on top, you want to be super sure that your ink is dry. Otherwise, you're going to have some bleeding as you ink blend over your stamping. So that's why I prefer to stamp first, or stencil first and then stamp later, which is what you'll see me do. So as I finished up here, I used Peachy Keen, Tangerine Dream, and then In Your Face Orange. And that In Your Face Orange was just a little bit too in your face. So I went back to layer 3A and went over a little bit more with Peachy Keen to help blend those oranges together. You can see how quickly that gorgeous tropical floral image came together. Now I want to stamp on top of it to create that black outline and really help this stand out. One of the ways I found to make this easy to line up is to stamp on a piece of vellum or acetate first. I'm using my Raven Hybrid Ink along with my Stampendable tool, and I'm just going to look through and make sure that I got that lined up in my Misty, and I did. I did pretty good, so I'm going to stamp that right on top of the image, but for just a minute, I kind of played around with the idea of keeping this vellum over the top of my image. But I decided to go with the bold of the original ink blending piece that I used. And I will come back with another video tomorrow and show you how I used that vellum piece. So definitely come back to my YouTube channel tomorrow to see how I used that piece, because nothing goes to waste in my craft room. Once I have that black tropical floral image stamped on top of my ink blending, I'm going to go ahead and take the tropical floral die and line that up right over my image, add some tape, and run this through my die cutting machine. And just like that, I'm going to have an easy stenciled, colored image ready to go. It really didn't take me, I think it took me probably 10 minutes, and I'm a slow blender, so it doesn't take that long at all. Definitely quicker than coloring with markers or pencils. Now, as I'm finishing up the card, I'm going to go with one of my go-to designs. I thought about using a paper pad that's new for from this release, but I just wasn't, none of the painted garden patterns were jiving with my tropical floral image there. So I will use that painted garden paper pack in tomorrow's video. So again, come back for that tomorrow. Instead, I'm going to use the new brocade stencil. And this is something that you've probably seen me do before, is mask off and just ink blend on the bottom portion. So I'm probably stenciling up maybe the bottom third. Again, using Raven Hybrid ink here, and I am using the new blender brushes from LDRS Creative, and I have to say they work wonderfully. This was my first time using them, and they're so smooth. I absolutely love them. So I inked up the bottom of my slimline card with that brocade stencil, and then I'm going to mask off where I've stenciled, and I'm going to come in with some Peachy Keen and some Tangerine Dream hybrid inks, what I used for those center flowers. I'm going to come in and do some ink blending on the top of my card. I like to use usually two or three main colors on a card and then have others be accent colors. So there's a lot of green in my image, and then there's just a little bit of pink, and I wanted to kind of make that orange more pronounced. I really love how the Peachy Keen and the Tangerine Dream inks work together. So I'm going to go ahead and just do a light blend, and you can see that I'm not really taking a lot of care to make sure it's super smooth, because that tropical floral image is so large, it's going to cover up most of it anyway. Just to create a little bit of an even seam, I'm going to add a thin 1/4 inch thick strip of cardstock right where the brocade stenciling meets my orange ink blending, and then I'll trim that away. I'll go ahead and add foam tape behind my tropical floral image, as well as the sentiment that I stamped from the tropical floral stamp set and just fussy cut out with my scissors. And this is my finished card. I hope that you're inspired and that you love these layering stencils as much as I do. All of these items are available right now in the LDRS Creative Shop. Thank you so much for watching. I have linked and listed all of the items I used on today's card in the video description below. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. Thank you again very much for watching this video. If you liked this video and you'd like to see more from me, please hit that subscribe button that is on the screen now. And here are a few other videos that I thought you might enjoy.